I usually do not make reviews for lenses like that because you see them in the beginning and you see the price, that it's about $400 along with this extra lens hood, and you say, ah, it's a cheap lens, you know, for amateurs and stuff. So I bought it for my daughter to use with her D500, because the 70-200 FX lens that she was using was a little on the heavy and big size. So when I try it on, I was focusing from 1.5 meters, turning the camera instantly to something that was far away, to infinity, before my eye could catch the motion. I'm not kidding you. And that's in low light, overcast winter at around 4 p.m. At the end of November. It is insanely fast autofocus and so quiet that you don't even realize it's happening. It's as if there's something magic inside the lens that does the focusing. That's how it feels. It doesn't feel mechanic at all, although it is mechanic, because it's so quiet and fast. The image quality was excellent, and I was surprised by this because I found no chromatic aberrations or fringing, and you know how allergic I am to both of these, especially fringing. Wide open at the entire zoom range, no fringing when I was shooting a specific tree branch against the whitish winter clouds, which is a recipe for fringing. It's like you're going after it. It's like you're trying to achieve fringing, and it had no fringing. The VR performance, amazing. No shaken pictures whatsoever. Very small and light, and compared to its FX cousin, the older 70-300 FX VR lens, this one performs better throughout the zoom range, and especially in the sensitive range between 250 and 300, where the old full-frame lens had both fringing and softness. This one stays sharp throughout the zoom range. It's sharper, actually. It's a sharper lens than its FX cousin on the D500. The minus now, it has no buttons. However, you're using a lens like that, you really only need the zoom ring, which is huge. It covers the entire area of the lens, so it's easier to use when you have a huge zoom ring here. This is the focusing ring, and you're probably never going to use it. All functions are controlled from the camera menus, including the VR. Now, for some people, this may be a minus, because we're used to having these on the lens. However, it's not like you're going to use this lens to take, you know, let's say professional landscapes where you're going to need to turn off the VR. So it works just fine this way, and it keeps the cost lower, and it eliminates two or three more potential points of failure, right? It's a simpler construction this way. Now, at 300 millimeter, the image is sharp, but aperture reduces to 6.3. However, there is no need to step it down further from wide open, because sometimes you buy lenses that stay at 5.6 and they have fringing as you approach 250-300 millimeter, and you need to step them down anyway to 6.3. so it works the same. And the one minus, you have to buy the one actual minus. You have to buy the lens hood separately. Don't forget to buy it though, because you're going to get significantly better image with the lens hood attached. It's the lens hood is about $25 or $30. I bought this from Robert's Camera. I didn't expect its amazing performance. It surprised me. The autofocus, especially, it's like magic. I've never seen anything like that. Even with the 70-200 FL Nikon that I rented once, and even the rent was expensive on this lens, And this one has a faster and more quiet autofocus. I mean, faster, maybe a tiny bit, like a hair faster, but it's still at that level. So you can only imagine what's how big of a bargain this lens is, which you can buy along with the hood at around $420. I think that's the best choice. It's better than the 55-300, which I sold because it was soft towards the end. And the autofocus was not as fast as this one. I like this one better. So this is one of the three lenses that I have for my daughter with her Nikon D500, and I highly recommend it. Thanks a lot. Bye.